Hello everybody and welcome to the commentary on Resident Evil 4 for the channel of Nat One Crew. This is Ghost the Cat. I'm here with my new friend
Danndermann.
That's Danndermann. Don't forget it. Here we go. We're going to talk commentary over a game of Resident Evil 4 that I started, and it should be fun. Hopefully I have a lot of laughs.
I miss that whole Resident Evil thing.
Oh yeah. That's always a good Resident Evil. And then he goes, four.
Yeah, I've never played Resident Evil 4. I played Resident Evil 5.
Yes. I remember playing Resident Evil 5. That was like the first game that you ever had on the PlayStation 3, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Or one of them. It was a good game. I don't really remember a lot of the story, though. Is it more of like a... Well, I'm sure there's a story to it. I just don't remember.
I really can't remember much. I remember you start out in Africa.
Yeah. Maybe it really is just like a co-op shoot-em-up kind of game more than it is a story game.
No, it had a story to it. Okay. But you can do co-op on it. Yeah. I know it references this game a few times. I remember it mentioning it.
Yeah. I think it'll be interesting, like, as I play the game, to see if you pick up on any of the things, because mm-hmm. there's a lot of stuff to this game. Like,
now I think they're the same zombies.
Yeah,
that was in Resident Evil 5. Like, they're the same strand.
Yeah,
of the virus.
I believe so. I could be wrong. I'd have to look into the nerdy elements of it.
Mm-hmm.
But, I'm trying to think. It's purple liquid in its form. That's how they inject it. I don't know if that has ever shown how they injected it in the African zombies.
Now, is he in Spain? I'm pretty sure he's in Spain.
Yeah, I think he's in Spain, probably like Barcelona or something. I'm probably not Barcelona, I don't know. I think they say something like a rural part of Europe or something.
Yeah.
I mean, that could just be really good guessing. I haven't seen this in a long time, you know. It's been a while. Anyway.
He's got that early thousands hair look.
Yes, early thousands.
Sure. Yeah. Like he wants to be an anime character without being an anime character.
He kind of almost looks like he could be in, what's that one anime that's Attack on Titan?
Kinda yeah. Or, what's the other one? The Seven Deadly Sins.
Oh, is that an anime? Because I've only seen like, a mobile game of it.
Good. You should watch it. It's good.
Okay, what about the mobile game? Have you played it?
I have not.
It's like... It looks super good. Every time I just don't play it, because I'm like, I feel like this is one of those animes that just has a ton of big boob chicks in it.
You're right, in a way.
Oh, man, okay. Here's that part of the road trip where you're just like, man, I really gotta pee, dude. Like, it's been too long.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna go on the side in the woods here. There's no, you know, virus-infected zombies. So this is how people got around before Uber was a thing. You just had to have the police drive you to where you wanted to go.
In the middle of nowhere.
Yeah. When you're trying to save the president's daughter.
Oh, this is that part of the trip when you go to take a leak and then you're getting scared.
Oh yeah, no, that does happen.
That's happened so many times.
Oh man. And he's just, and that's exactly what you do. You're just like, what the? Okay, all right, it's okay. It's okay. There's no virus-infected zombies out here. It's not gonna happen. What was the other thing I was gonna say? Dag nabbit. I don't remember. Oh, one thing I like to think about with this game is it seems like it's kind of, I can't remember when this game came out. I think it's like 05, 06. It could have been later, though. Which means it's like right in the, I mean, I don't think it came out in 2008, so it can't be Obama. I mean, it's got to be like Bush era. So, like, I like to think, like, when you're saving the president's daughter, it's like, you know, come up with the president.
2005.
So it would have been Bush for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Did George Bush ever have a daughter?
I don't know.
I don't know either. Look that up. I'm just kidding. It would be funny if her name was Ashley. That'd be funny.
I'm looking it up right now.
Okay.
I'm gonna find out.
That's good.
It's Jenna and Barbara.
Dag nabbit. Why'd they have to name her Barbara? Like, you already had one. Okay, so here's one aspect of the video game that's kind of interesting. Did they have any kind of communication thing like this in 5?
No, I don't think so. I know they talked to each other.
This kind of reminds me of, like, a Metal Gear Solid thing, really. Yeah. Because I know they do that.
Snake!
I feel like that's where this gets more popular from. I'm trying to think. There might be a little bit of similarities between the creators. I don't know if it's the same guy, but it might be.
Oh, the bird's flying. That's very reminiscent of 5.
If I would have slowed down and shot the birds, I would have got free like ammo or herbs or something. So I kind of
I remember doing that too in 5.
Yeah. So I kind of rush through this a little bit. I don't rush through the cutscenes because I'm like, I might as well let that play out to, you know, give the full story. But yeah, this is like the first interaction he has. This guy's not gonna be like full on zombie, but he's, you know, he's kind of like a milder version of the. He's just really aggressive. Donkey, I don't know. You know what video game Donkey is?
Yeah.
He live streamed with his girlfriend, and when the guy turns around, he's like, "Oh no, an old man!" Oh man, that's funny.
Yeah, it has all those aspects from 5: the over the shoulder, the walking into a cutscene, and then the jumping.
Oh yeah, I'm not sure how much the button layout is, but shoot, kick.
Yeah.
And then if they're not dead yet, go up to them a knife. That's the name of the game. Really. Now, one thing I like about The Evil Within is that it doesn't really let you do that. You have to come up and sneak behind the zombie, and you get a stab animation, and that's your one-hit kill for that. But also, you can do things like... get them all, like all the zombies grouped up in a bunch together, and go to like a gasoline stain or something on the ground and shoot it, and they'll all burn. I think this game might have options like that, maybe explosive barrels, but not that I can think of. If I check right there, it just tells me like it doesn't look like he's completely infected, but you know. I think it literally like, says like not a zombie. And so, I'm gonna jump out here. And try to get out of that situation.
Like, hey, you get dropped off there by the police, and you're just having to fight for your life.
Yeah. I don't know if it'd be funner if they joined me or not. I kind of feel like it would have been interesting to see how that would have gone. Now, I'm trying to get used to the controls again, but before this, I played it a few times, so.
Yeah, I think this is... The zombies are doing the same thing as the other ones did in 5.
Yeah. It'd be interesting.
That music that makes you, like, really...
Playing everything out.
Anxious.
Yeah. Yeah, that too. It's kind of funny how the game starts out this way. Like, it does a good job of just giving you one guy to go after. And I didn't realize it the first time, but I actually killed one of the guys back there. I thought they were all three alive the first time I played it. It's kind of hard to tell when they go down, though. They're either going to die or they're going to come back up. So you just kind of got to wait for it. See, like that guy. Didn't realize he was dead. Did they use herbs in the Resident Evil 5?
They did.
Okay.
You can combine them together and make different potions.
Yeah.
Or whatever, I don't know if it's called potion, I can't remember, but...
This one, I don't know if it's potions either, but yeah, they kind of mix into a container, you'll see.
You can make it and then make it the health potions and such.
Yeah. Did 5 have a suitcase?
Suitcase? What do you mean?
Okay, you'll see. Now that the typewriter comes up... on that Donkey live stream, him and his wife were playing, and she goes up to the save, and when she pops up the typewriter, you see it says, like, 40 hours of playtime, and she clicks right over that, and he's like, "Babe, you just erased my save!" He was like, I was on the last boss. Oh my goodness. And here's a little doggy you can help out.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I like the reload animation.
Oh yeah, just the, what do you mean, like when he just reloads?
Yeah, when he just reloads, I like that.
That's such a little thing to like, but I kind of understand it. This game has a lot of, like, I don't think it's really, like, well known as much for its, like, I mean, its story's pretty good and stuff, but I think really what it is, like, the way it sets up your character and the way it feels. It takes some time to get used to, like, the button layout, but after you do, I think it's actually better than a lot of other games, in my opinion, because it makes you get used to it. Instead of just being like, this is like Call of Duty controls, you know.
I've never seen a video game that when you have ammo still in your clip and you reload, it just automatically reloads your thing. And then when you get through all the ammo again, all your clips are automatically all the way full. I've never seen a game where when you take a clip out and you reload with a full clip, that you reload with a clip that's already had what was left originally. That would be more realistic.
Yeah, so you're saying, like, in real life, if you had a clip that had 6 bullets in it, you're not just going to throw that away and put a new clip with, like, 10 bullets.
Yeah. And then if you kept that one with 6, and when you reload, it's not going to have, like, 6 plus, like, 3 more that was also in your inventory.
I have an alarm going off. Stupid. Okay, turn that off.